Yo, Luca, you know I'm hosting the award show? Hosting the award show. Yeah. Wow.
That's quite a reception from my teammate. You know who's hosting the award show?
You.
Yeah.
I know. I'm excited about it.
Jeez!
I saw the post yesterday. With the behind.
Y'all ready? Let's go.
Hello, my name is David Farrar and I have the privilege to serve as the president of McMaster University. Normally, I'd be joining you in person at the Student Athletes Award Banquet, one of my favorite events of the year. Of course, this is anything but a normal year. Not only did the campus close and most of your courses moved online, but the competitive seasons were canceled for all of McMaster's student athletes. I can only imagine the disappointment that that has meant for all of you. For some, it has meant the end of your competitive university career. For others, we'll be coming back, but it will be some time before competitive sport returns to life as we knew it before the pandemic. If you're like me, you know that being physically active is not only a good way to handle stress and stay fit, but it also brings balance into your life. I hope you found ways to achieve that balance this year by staying active and finding new ways to bring people together and raise important issues. In fact, this year, we've seen powerful examples of McMaster student athletes raising concerns about systemic racism and social justice at the university itself. I know many of you have taken your team building and leadership skills into the virtual arena, leading events to promote equity and mentoring young people. I'm very proud of the way you've stepped up this year. I hope you'll take positive lessons away from this year of living differently. You are not able to represent your university or to dream of contending for a championship. But there's much more to being part of a team. The American gymnast, Mary Lou Retton, who won a bunch of Olympic medals, said, "Trophies collect dust, memories last forever." I hope as you gather together in this virtual world with your fellow athletes and family members that you're surrounded by great memories and that there are many more to come. Enjoy the awards.
I thought we were doing casual.
I thought we were doing formal.
Not again. Said, come on.
Well, you just said casual.
Well, you said formal.
There we go. Hey, what's up, everyone? My name is Brandon Bernard. I'm a third-year student athlete on the McMaster men's basketball team.
And my name's Stacey Warner, and I'm a fourth-year athlete on the women's rugby team.
And we'll be your host for tonight's socially distanced 97th Annual Marauder Student Athletes Award Show.
Like everyone else, I had high expectations for 2020 and was very disappointed when COVID-19 turned everything upside down. Although there were many things to be disappointed about, like missing Snooty's karaoke, it's important to recognize the perseverance of Marauder Nation during these unprecedented times.
The past year has been wild to say the least, but that's not to say that there wasn't any good that came out of it as well. And what better way to ease into the new year than to give out some awards, right? So stay tuned and grab a snack because I had...
Brandon, I think your Wi-Fi... Screw it. It's time for our first award of the night, the Joyce Wignall Award.
The Joyce Wignall Award for teams with exceptional community involvement. Baseball.
Through the quest for CF, for the Movember campaign that they ran, and for the virtual tours with the Children's Hospital, the team should be extremely proud of what they have done through this year of COVID. For all three events, members of this team took part throughout the entire province, some of whom have never ever met as one another on this team. So for that, I'm completely grateful, and I look forward to next year.
Women's basketball.
Whether it's motion ball, Think Pink campaign, and really the pivot that our team made, and the creativity in coming up with a virtual concept this year for such a big event was really outstanding on their part, and I want to congratulate them for all their hard work and commitment, and everybody in the department that took part in that. Giving back is a big part of our team culture, and so to my team, congrats ladies, proud of you as always.
Men's volleyball.
Did a really good job in our outreach program this year around the Movember campaign, led by a couple of our leadership council members, Bennett Swan and Liam Irwin. The team kind of rallied around and set a goal to surpass last year's fundraising. I believe last year was around 5,000. Their goal this year was in and around 7. And they blew it out of the water. I think they raised over $12,000, which ended up being second overall in Canada.
And the winner is men's volleyball. The team raised more than $12,000 this year through the Movember Canada campaign, a tremendous effort that propelled them to second in all of U sports. Players with the men's volleyball program selflessly volunteered their support for a number of department initiatives, including Bell Let's Talk Day, the VLC's Mental Health Week, Think Pink, and International Women's Day.
Congratulations to our finalists. We'd now like to take a moment to honor our fourth year Plaque Award winners. The fourth year Plaque Award is given out to McMaster student athletes who have dedicated 4 years of their hard work and commitment to representing the departments of athletic and recreation.
We'll see what's about to happen next, okay? Okay, okay, we'll see what's about to happen next, okay? Okay, okay, we'll see what's about to happen. Hey, hey, we'll see what's about to happen. I'm making a change today. I've been taking the pain away. I heard you was giving your chain away. That's kind of like giving your fame away.
For all of our fourth year athletes, expect to see an email from Claire Arsenault to get your plaque award.
Big shout out to all our fourth year athletes. Moving on to our next segment, with so much time spent at home, I know a lot of our fellow Marauders listen to a lot more music than usual. We decided to see how our coaches felt about some of these songs with a segment we like to call Coaches React. Spin that.
I don't know any of this. I'm gonna be bad.
So none of them are lyrically inappropriate. Okay.
This is on Tim's head. Did you guys sanitize? Okay. All right. All right.
So you want me to just put these on and listen, or
you can pass it on?
And what do I do with it?
You're the man. You're smart. You're smart.
We'll just play some music. Talk along if you want. The more you share, the better.
Sure. Okay.
If you can hear us.
Oh, this could be many people. Oh! I can't name. Do you want me to name the tunes?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
Let me yell.
Look, it fits my hair. I cannot name the tune. Oh, the Jonas Brothers.
Hey!
As a youngster, they're young there, eh? Doesn't Nick Jonas want to be an astronaut now? I'm waiting till you put Jordan Vang's playlist on there, because it's not any of those, I'm pretty sure.
No telling where I'm feeling.
I have no idea. But this may be Jordan Vang. Yes, definitely. No, I wouldn't be able to name it. Dram? This is definitely Jordan Vang. Clean, this is the clean version. Sort of. Look at how many bleeps are on there. Come on now.
Oh my God. I don't know. The baby? Little baby! Yeah. Ah. It's hard to keep up with little baby, the baby.
I've heard it, but I don't. Yeah. That sounds like my team. That sounds like my team.
Let's keep it real. Oh, come on, man. Why the man that's speaking still? I heard you and her doing a thing. It's the English dude. I don't know. I can't remember his name right now, but you know, it's Diggs, or I don't remember his name or something like that. But it's in my head, but I don't really know who this is. Fredo? Fredo?
This is my song. This is my song. Where's Erin Burns when I need her? This is the one Erin would always sing it, coach, sing it, coach. One moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he's all calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth. The words don't come out. That would always come on at summer camp, and Erin Burns and Hillary Hanukkah and all the girls that would be at camp, that would come on and I'd be over on the side singing and they'd all be laughing at me. And
it's a new generation, man. It's, but the beats are great. So, you know, it's something I can just go like this, you know?
More than anything, I love hearing the team sing on the bus. It's like, honestly, one of my favorite parts of going on a road trip is when they get singing in the back and they're all harmonizing and doing their piece. It's, we just sit at the front as coaches and we all kind of look at each other and just smile and kind of.
Well, I'll bet you right now that Jordan would dance to the dram piece for sure. She was working on her beats the other day.
So your kids aren't allowed to listen to this stuff?
Not right now.
Not right now.
Not right now. We're listening to Baby Shark and all types of Sesame Street songs.
Oh, it's all bada, but the beat goes on. Da da dum da dum. In the music, the moment you own.
Wow, I think Coach Burns is the next Eminem.
Honestly, that was wild.
Let's give out our second award of the night, the Les Prince Award.
The Les Prince Award for outstanding leadership and community service. Brandon Bernard, Men's Basketball Communication Studies.
He's a kid that brings a ton of energy to our team day in and day out, regardless if he plays or doesn't play. And his ability to really want to step out into the community, not just in the McMaster community, but his community that he's been raised up in since he was a kid, just shows that he really wants to give back to wherever he's come from.
Tristan Lindo, Men's Basketball Communication Studies.
This is a young man that's is taking great stride in, or making great strides and really trying to step out and be vocal and help out in the McMaster community here at the university, but also in the local community by just trying to moderate different panels and really help out and speak and use his voice to really help promote change for not just the department, but even for our McMaster men's basketball team.
Peyton Schenk, women's rugby, human behavior.
First of all, congratulations, Peyton, on being a finalist for the Les Prince Award. This award recognizes your contribution to the community, not just at McMaster, but our community at large. for all of your hard work on anti-racism and really trying to fight for systemic change within the system itself.
Bennett Swan, men's volleyball history.
Bennett Swan has matured into one of the best leaders we've ever had in our program. This year, through his Movember campaign, or leading the Movember campaign, and other programs that he's done around mental health, he's really blossomed into the type of person we believe McMaster volleyball players aspire to become.
And the winner is Bennett Swan, men's volleyball. In November, Bennett challenged the men's volleyball team to participate in the Movember campaign, leading his team to raise a staggering $12,085. As Movember came to a close, Bennett began working on a second entrepreneurial project called Board in the House, with all profits going to the Gifts of Light Foundation at the Center for Addiction and Mental Health. With only 1 month of production, they delivered more than 300 kits, amounting in more than 5,000 in donations. Bennett also played a leadership role in the conversation for gender equity at the annual Women in Sport and Leadership panel discussion as a moderator. Congratulations to Bennett Swan, winner of the Les Prince Award.
As a tradition, we like to recognize our amazing coaches who have achieved significant milestones this year with their programs.
Andy Duffield, 5 years. Andy Duffield took over women's water polo head coaching duties in 2015 and quickly made his mark as the squad captured the OUA silver medal and he was named OUA Coach of the Year. Since then, in the new National Collegiate Water Polo League, Andy has guided his team to a second silver medal in 2017, repeating with Coach of the Year honors. Despite not being an OUA sport anymore, under Andy's leadership, he helps ensure the women's water polo playing opportunities continue at McMaster.
Ken Oda, 10 years. It didn't take long for Ken Oda to make his mark on the McMaster fast pitch team. In 2009, his first year with the Marauders, the squad promptly won the OIWFA championship. Since then, the team has taken home provincial bronze medals in both 2016 as well as 2019, Ken's 10th season with the team. A McMaster graduate himself, Ken is a chiropractor who is also a certified coach in curling in addition to softball.
Gray Fairley, 5 years. After spending 7 seasons as an assistant coach from 1995 to 2002, Gray Fairley took the reins as head coach of both the men's and women's swimming programs for the 2015 to 2016 season. Gray was most recently pivotal in the hosting of the 2020 OUA Championships, a championship where his women's team captured OUA silver and the men captured OUA bronze. For his team's outstanding achievements, Gray was named 2020 OUA Coach of the Year. An accomplished swimmer in his own right, Gray was a decorated athlete with the Marauders and was inducted into the McMaster Hall of Fame in 2007.
This year has been tough for a number of reasons. Many in our McMaster community have suffered the loss of someone near and dear to them. We'd like to take a moment to remember some of the incredible members of the Marauder family who have gone too soon.
It is indeed a privilege and an honor to say a few words about one of McMaster's champions of philanthropy, Mr. David Braley. David was a great friend to McMaster, and we miss him dearly. His philanthropy can be felt across the entire McMaster campus, but most especially in the Faculty of Health Sciences, and of course the tremendous facilities that are the David Braley Athletic Center and the David Braley Sports Medicine and Rehabilitation Center. As a former student athlete, David loved to visit campus to watch the Marauders play at the Ron Joyce Stadium, and his love of football was clearly evident in the steadfast support to the Department of Athletics and Recreation and through the M Club, which he founded. David's name and legacy will live on for decades to come, and I know he would have been very touched that we remembered him on this wonderful occasion.
Out of
all the people that I've ever crossed paths with, Jason Buckle was amongst those that has had, you know, the biggest and most meaningful impact on my life. And I don't mean that just in terms of my wrestling career. I mean, like, in terms of my life. And I'm confident that this is the case for countless other people as well. Jason was a kind, lighthearted, and hilarious person. He taught me how to enjoy the small things in life while also inspiring me to go after my biggest goals and dreams. He always made it a point to help others regardless of skill level or talent. I think we're all gonna truly, truly miss Jason Buckle. He may be gone, but the difference that he's made in our lives will remain with us forever.
I want to pay respect to Coach Nathan Galone. His 1 year on the McMaster staff was as impactful as anybody's. Nice guys finish where their effort, energy, and heart takes them. And this nice man added value in every quiet corner of my locker room and looked to take no credit for anything that he did. He will be missed and he will be remembered. And he made an impact. Thank you, Coach. Rest in peace.
I am very honored and humbled to have been asked to say a few words about our dear friend Kelly Dunham. Could say more than a few words, but mostly tonight just want to acknowledge that it's still hard to believe it's coming up for a year that we lost our dear friend. Kelly, you're remembered every day. The impact you had on everybody that you came in contact with, your colleagues in our department, the coaching staff, and most particularly the student athletes. I think it's really fitting that we're celebrating you tonight when we're celebrating the student athletes, because we all know how near and dear you held them to your heart. We will try to move forward and take the spirit of Kel with us in everything that we do, trying to be good people and take that big smile and big hug and big heart into all of our endeavors and make sure that you're always remembered and that you carry on through the years with us. We love you and we miss you.
Our condolences to each and every single one of their families, friends, and loved ones. We will always remember you and your contributions to McMaster. Up next is our third award of the night, the Outstanding Female Graduate Award.
The Outstanding Female Graduate Award, exhibiting the spirit of McMaster. Isabel Lay, swimming, health sciences.
She has been a leader. She's been the team captain for the last 2 years. In her very first year, she won the 2018 Rookie of the Year for the OUA. She is an outstanding academic, as she in 2018, 19, and 20, she was a U Sport Academic All-Canadian. She also gives to the community as a Special Olympics coach, as well as a peer tutor within her own classes.
Jesse Nairn, women's volleyball, commerce.
It's pretty cool when you can write a script and we kind of follow along pretty closely in an athlete's career to watch them evolve over time. And Jess has done that and at the same time given back to the university and to her volleyball program. Triple, you know, fourfold even, when it comes to guiding and mentoring those who are coming after her.
Sabrina Schindel, women's lacrosse, geography, and environmental science.
She's an excellent student. She's an elite performer on the field. And in addition, some of her most important contributions have come as a result of her efforts to build a stronger and more inclusive community at McMaster. Many of these efforts focused on improving student athlete mental health, efforts that will pay dividends long after Sabrina graduates. And I'm happy that Sabrina has been nominated for this year's Outstanding Female Graduate Award. Congratulations.
Brianna Weiss, field hockey, kinesiology.
Thank you so much for the impact that you had on our field hockey program at McMaster. With us entering the OUA season within the year or two, we truly do have to say thank you for your efforts and dedication to the program. With that being said, the team is going to miss you on and off the field, your fundraising efforts, your overall team management, and just your passion for the program and for the team. It truly does show, and we are absolutely going to miss you in the future. So best of luck.
And the winner is Brianna Weiss, field hockey. Brianna's optimistic spirit, ability to lead others, and her commitment to the success of the women's field hockey program is both genuine and endearing. A three-year co-captain of the team, Brianna has had a significant impact on the team's entrance into the OUA. In March 2021, Weiss helped lead the planning and execution of Women in Sports and Leadership, an online panel conversation aimed at creating gender equity. Brianna has spearheaded several fundraisers for her team, including a Women in Sports t-shirt initiative, and is currently working on an alumni networking platform to connect graduated field hockey athletes to current team members. Weiss was also the volunteer coordinator at McMaster's Physical Activity Center of Excellence.
I think that when I reflect on my time being a Marauder, I get this like really overwhelming sense of gratitude for the people that have come into my life. Like through MAC Athletics, I found so many of just like my humans, like people that support me so much, people that I support. I love them, they love me. And like I think the human connections that I've made through this time have just like helped to reaffirm me as a person, reaffirm like my capabilities, have helped me like build this confidence in knowing what I'm capable of. And I think that that has been something that's helped me go seek out opportunities. And then I've experienced this like amazing growth from first year where like I wasn't involved in sports at all to being in my fifth year. And like I think back at all that I've accomplished, and I just like can't help but like attribute that to all of the people that I've like connected with along the way. So thank you.
Congratulations to all of our finalists. What a phenomenal career they've had. With so much time away from the field, I didn't know what to do with myself. I tried keeping busy by learning TikTok dances, cutting my own bangs, and I even bought a ukulele that is now collecting dust in my room. Here are some things you've all gotten up to this past year.
Go, Tori!
Dunk packages during practice, McMaster edition.
Top right penny.
On to our next grad award. It's time to find out who the recipient of the Dr. Ray Johnson Award is.
The Dr. Ray Johnson Award, Outstanding Graduating Male Student Athlete. Kwasi Adepoku, Men's Basketball Kinesiology.
Over the last 4 years, Kwasi has literally embodied what it means to be a MAC student athlete, right? His leadership has been great. He is by far the one guy on our team that is a go-to person when it comes to, hey, let's just keep things positive. Let's make sure that if this guy's feeling bad, that we all pick him up together. So Kwasi has been amazing. It's a no-brainer for him to essentially have this Ray Johnson Award, but he is the He is the guy that exemplifies Matt.
Jordan Pereira, men's volleyball, Commerce.
To just watch the maturation process of Jordan as a leader has been outstanding. So he's a tremendous athlete, which speaks volumes to the fact that he's likely going to be on the National A-team roster this summer. But as well, the kind of influence that he's had and the legacy that he's left. For those that have played for our program in the past, they know that leaving it better than they found it is something that we instill in our student athletes. And there's no doubt in my mind that Jordan's done that.
Jacob Zott, football, Commerce.
He's a ball of energy and a source of positivity that never yields. His parents, hands-on in every parent group meeting there ever was, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. You only get out of something what you put into it. Jacob Zott is such a deserving finalist for this award because he put everything into his McMaster experience. Congrats, Jacob.
And the winner is Kwesi Adupoku, men's basketball. Kwesi has become a catalyst for change and has persistently pushed for dialogue and to engage the McMaster community by launching and hosting the Reach Series, an ongoing workshop that aims to help people find their self-worth. An active member of MAC Athletes Care, the Varsity Leadership Committee, an athlete academic mentor, basketball camp counselor, and Joan Buttle Service Desk customer service representative, Kwesi's wide impact can be felt throughout campus and beyond.
When I think about it, there's honestly just too much to be grateful for with my time at MAC. You know, when I take a step back and think about how hard I had to work just to get here as a walk-on, and how hard I had to work to, you know, continuously make my way throughout, you know, just consistency and resilience are just some of the things that I've taken with me then and will just take with me for the rest of my life. You know, and I just want to spend the rest of this time just thanking people, but honestly, just want to thank my team for being there for me in so many ways. I want to thank my coaches. You're all just amazing people. Just the admin who have made me feel like more than a student athlete here. You know, Stalewood, y'all have helped me through so much. And just honestly, you, the Marauder community, you know, in whatever capacity I got to know you, like, I've just been happy to be a part of this, and I appreciate y'all for real.
Hey, congratulations. Before we go on to our next award, let's take a look at our graduating athletes as we celebrate their time at McMaster.
University here as a curious high school graduate. I had no idea that the strangers I met would become my family, and for that fact alone, I'm incredibly grateful. Between our traditions of winning and getting large Baconator combos before games, that's two burger patties, six strips of bacon, cheese, mayo, ketchup, and an exquisite brioche bun from Wendy's. With the offensive line guys, I've learned countless lessons like getting a little bit better every day and to not be a complete meathead. Sadly, I could only do one of the two. And thank you to all the coaches, staff, and family that made this the experience of a lifetime.
Suddenly these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget. And all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old
days. I'm very grateful I chose this school because of all the great people I've been able to surround myself with. Thank you to all my teammates, my coaches, Dave, Ian, Pete, Brinks, Steve. Thank you to all the therapy staff for keeping us healthy, Carly, Pusky, and all the student therapists I've been able to work with. Thank you to all our S&C staff, Ben, Zach, Dylan, and all the interns. And thank you to everyone who worked upstairs in the office who worked so hard for us to be able to have such great game days at Burridge. TJ, Connor, just to name a few. And thank you to Claire and Muad for setting up this event. Thank you for making my time here so special.
tough to put my journey at McMaster into words. I've grown so much as a person, as well as an athlete. I've had the opportunity to cross paths with so many incredible individuals, including my coaches, Tim, Nate, and Alex, just to name a few, Carly, Ben, Chris, Zach, Dylan, and all the incredible strength coaches that have kept me healthy and strong, the teammates that I've had over the past 5 years. I am so grateful for the friendships that I've gained, Bree and Sabrina and the rest of the VLC committee, as well as the athletic department, Sean, Mark, Muad, and especially Kelly. I really miss you. I'm so grateful for everyone that I've crossed paths with over the past 5 years. I am so thankful for the belief that you've had in me, and I'm really gonna miss you all. And thank you for the best 5 years.
You don't know, whoa, whoa, what you got, whoa, whoa, till it goes, whoa, whoa, till it's gone. Whoa, whoa, you don't know.
This year has been nothing short of a difficult one. Time and time again, you, our student athletes, have displayed resiliency and perseverance despite all the uncertainty. For some, your athletic careers may be coming to a close, but know you will always be Marauders. This will always be your home. Although a difficult year, this year has produced a lot of dialogue that will lead to progress and ultimately change on a number of important issues. We're hopeful to return to competition sooner rather than later, and when we do, we'll be stronger for what we've gone through together. And now, on behalf of Director of Athletics and Recreation, Sean Burt, we are proud to present the Director's Award.
The Director's Award for outstanding contributions to the Department of Athletics and Recreation. The recipient of the Director's Award is Sabrina Schindel, Women's Lacrosse.
I am not sure if any other student athlete exemplifies the spirit of McMaster better than Sabrina. Sabrina has dedicated a considerable amount of time to several athletic department initiatives, our varsity leadership committee, their mental health week, MAC Athletes Care, Roots Youth Center, and as a youth volunteer coach. Sabrina has been a supportive member of all activities in this department for over the last 4 years. She has been an outstanding student athlete both on and off the field. She was our recipient last year of the Les Prince Award. She has received the RBC Insurance Athletic Leadership Award in both 2019 and 2020. She was an OUA All-Star First Team in 2018 and an OUA Second Team All-Star in 2015 and 2017. She has been a tremendous leader for our women's lacrosse program, as well as for our overall department in their initiatives in the community. Sabrina, we say congratulations and thank you for everything you've done for McMaster Athletics and Recreation.
When I got to MAC, I was just a kid hoping for a spot on the lacrosse team so I could play the game I love while getting my degree. As it turns out, joining the team meant joining the Marauder community, which was so much more than just sweating on alumni field in those final few hot months of every year. It meant amazing coaches and trainers who put in countless hours to helping me be the best I could be. It meant working with athletes from every team to try to make a difference at McMaster and in the Hamilton community. And it meant once-in-a-lifetime experiences that have shaped me into the person I am today. What I'll remember most when I'm done won't be my classes. It'll be those bus rides home with my team after a win, singing at the top of my lungs, just trying to soak up that amazing feeling you get when you've just done something incredible with people you love. Thank you, Mac, for these extraordinary past 5 years.
Thank you, Mark. This year has been nothing short of challenging. So much of what we get to do continues thanks to the tireless work and late nights by the staff and coaches within the departments of athletics and recreation.
Being able to train safely during a pandemic is only possible thanks to the work done by TJ Kelly, Ben Barami, Chris Puskas, Carly Vandergrant, Dave Fogarty, John Brown, and the rest of our performance coaching staff.
Thank you to our field therapists and sports med clinic staff, our coaches, our accounting team, alumni and student services, management, facility staffs, and marketing and communications. None of this would be possible without you. So from us to you, we want to say thank you.
Campus just doesn't seem the same without the student athletes.
I know. I can't wait for the time when we can all be together on campus again.
Honestly, it's going to be amazing.
Until then, we'll see you next year.
See you. Being able to train safely during a pandemic is only oh my gosh, Brandon!
I turned Southern on that.
Yeah, I know.
Spin it.
Okay.
Woohoo! Okay.
Go, Matt, go. Go, Matt, go.
I know. There's gonna be. Exactly. Thanks for tuning in.